So good morning everybody, this is Parminder, your trainer for S4HANA Simple Logistics. So first of all, welcome all of you in our demo session for S4HANA Simple Logistics. So in today's session, basically it's a demo session for our batch starting from the next weekend. So we will divide this session into the 5 parts and we'll try to complete this session within a 1 hour 15 minutes. So first part of the session will be the introduction. I will introduce myself and I will also ask you to introduce yourself and to set your expectation. Then we will go into the course content and the details that what actually there will be in the course, all of the materials and other things. Then quickly we'll go to the basics of SAP HANA. We'll learn a little bit of basics of SAP HANA. Then I will give you a glimpse of the demo, that how the HANA system looks like, how the HANA Studio will be there, and NetWeaver Business Client, and Fiori interface. So we'll have a look on that. Then we'll be having a question and answer session at last. I hope all of you can hear me very clearly and all of you can also see my screen. If you are facing any problem related to hearing me or seeing my screen, you can put your remarks on chat window so that our training support staff can help you to resolve your problem. So setting up the ground rules first for the meeting. So basically this is a standard ground rules which we follow for all of our training sessions. So keep yourself on mute if you are not speaking. Okay, if you are not speaking, keep yourself on mute. When you want to speak or when you want to ask any question, you can unmute yourself. We'll be having a question and answer session in the last 15 minutes, but feel free to ask questions anytime in between the session. You can unmute yourself and ask questions, or you can also use at the right hand side corner, you will see in your GoToMeeting there is a chat box there. So you can also type your question into the chat box. Okay, and if you want to leave the session and somehow if you are the somebody make you organizer, if you see end meeting for all, do not click on that button if you are leaving a meeting. Okay, and regarding the training material and the session notes for each of the session, we use OneNote to store the training notes. I will give an overview of OneNote and we share the access from there. And the other training materials related to certifications and other things also will be provided through separate mail or through the Google Drive access. So let me start myself, start this with the introduction of mine. Then I will go into the group to have introduction of yours one by one. So I'm having around 11 years of experience, more than 11 years of experience in SAP, and I have around more than 3 years of experience in SAP HANA. I started my career consulting with the supply chain modules, and I have worked for all of the supply chain modules like SD, MM, PP, QM, WM, all of the supply chain modules I have experience with. I started working on SAP HANA around 3 years back, and I have handled multiple projects, different kind of projects in SAP HANA and SAP S4HANA, including migration projects, implementation, proof of concepts, pilot projects. And during this session, I will be sharing with you the experience from my real project so that the training will help you when you go into the new project. This year, I have also applied for 2 SAP HANA Innovation Awards for our 2 of clients. One is AFS client and one is CPG client. We have applied for SAP HANA Innovation 2017 client. And I have represented the SAP HANA solution in the different forums, different webinars, and this year in the May, again, I'm going to present SAP HANA solution in Sapphire from my company. So if anybody of you are visiting Sapphire in Orlando in May, so have a get together there. So let's start with our training. So as we all know that we are sitting here all together putting our time on Sunday, we all know, we all smell that there is a transition is happening. Okay, a change is happening in the market, evolution is coming and innovations are coming, which is having a rush to go with new technologies to adopt the new innovations. Okay, that's why the SAP HANA is a big change. Okay, compared to the another releases of R3 or ECC, it's a big move by SAP, which makes SAP 5 to 10 years ahead from his competitors with that technology of SAP HANA. So that is a big change which is coming, and that's why all of us has a urge to learn the new technology and the new thing which is coming. So this target audience for this course is all of the supply chain consultant are the major target audience for this course. Okay, who are having some background experience in logistics and in logistics, any module, MM, ST, or any module of logistics, if the background experience is there, they can enhance their knowledge with SAP HANA and S4HANA. So the functional consultants are the major ones for this course. And this course has also, because it will be covering the whole S4HANA, so it will be also beneficial for solution architects, project managers, people having a higher number of experience, or program managers, so that it can give a overview of the whole about the S4HANA, how the S4HANA projects runs, and what are the things included for S4HANA projects. So a key note on that, for this course, it is required to have a basic knowledge in supply chain modules. Okay, we don't expect to have detailed knowledge, but basic knowledge is required for this course in the supply chain modules of SAP. Okay, and we don't require SAP HANA knowledge. Okay, although the S4 consultants will be requiring to have a SAP HANA knowledge, but SAP HANA knowledge is not a prerequisite for this course. So we'll be going in the earlier sessions, we'll be going into the detail of SAP HANA, what is the database and what kind of things it covers. So that knowledge we will be providing it to you. So if you don't know anything about SAP HANA, anything about the database technologies or anything, it's not required. We'll be providing that training to you. Let's go ahead to the next slide. Training content. So the training content involved in this training is designed like that way so that it can give you a knowledge about the curriculum, so that in future once the certification exam is launched, you can go ahead with the certification with that knowledge. So all of the materials which we are expecting, which will be part of certification, will also share that. And it's also designed in that way that it will also provide you it will also provide you knowledge once you go into a project, what kind of things you need to do in a project, how migration projects are run. So all of that knowledge will also be provided in this course. So first we'll go with the SAP HANA introduction. A little bit part we'll cover today, and then once we'll have a proper sessions, then we'll cover in detail of SAP HANA. We'll also first cover the S4HANA foundation part. Then in the later weeks, we'll be going into the detail of that. We'll also cover the deployment and architecture, which now becomes a very important, because S4HANA, earlier when the ECC was there, there was a simple concept of let's go with the ECC. But once the HANA comes, it has a lot of options. It has on-premises, okay, it has on-cloud, then you also have a hybrid scenario. Okay, so due to our different scenarios in cloud solution also, we have different things like HANA Cloud Enterprise, HEC, HANA Cloud Platform, and there's another people in the market who also provide the cloud solution for HANA like AWS. And recently, a couple of weeks back, HANA is having SAP is having a handshake with GCP. GCP is a Google Cloud Platform. Now, GCP will also provide platform for SAP HANA. So due to having this different things, and you know, clients are already there in ECC, and some of them will want to move to the S/4HANA. Some will be the very new, fresh greenfield project, some greyfield projects. So due to the different options there, different kind of projects are there, sometimes the architecture become complex. So we'll go into the detail in these two topics when we'll discuss about when client need to go to cloud or which clients are more suitable for on-premises. So that kind of things we'll be discussing here. Then SAP is having a new methodology which is called SAP Activate. We'll also have one session on SAP Activate methodology. SAP HANA replication and data modeling is a big topic. We'll be covering this in very detail in 3 to 4 sessions. So earlier, the function consultant were only using SAP GUI. SAP HANA is a really big change, where SAP HANA database access is provided to consultants. So consultants will be more powerful. And when we say they will be more powerful, it means that they should have a more knowledge to handle the database. So there is a lot of data modeling which function consultant can do, creating different kind of views and analytical views, calculations views, and then using that views for the analytics. So that is the biggest change coming with the SAP S/4HANA. So we'll cover that topic in detail. Then in the rest of the things, then we'll go into the detail of the logistics, that what are the things there which are going to change with the simple logistics. What are the changes coming in our sales modules? In enterprise management, what are the general changes coming? What are the material master related changes coming? Related to sourcing and procurement, what are the changes coming? What is the simplification list? How to use it? So that will be covered in our second part of the training, where we'll cover all of the simplifications. Then one of the big changes coming with the interface. So that is also our biggest change, which we consider the interface is changing. Earlier we were using only one interface, which is SAP GUI. Now SAP S/4HANA comes with two new interfaces, which is one is completely new, that is NetWeaver. And NetWeaver is not that new, it is old, but now it is comes as a standard package with S/4HANA. Then another one is Fiori. So we'll also discuss that what is the interfaces Fiori and NetWeaver, and how to implement that solutions for our clients, how to set up our roles for them, how to configure a Fiori dashboards, storyboards. So Fiori is a totally new concept and the new future of SAP. We are rather than SAP reports, user is asking data from SAP reports, SAP with the help of the function consultant will be producing a storyboards which can directly tell user what need to do without putting him in a single transaction code. Then at last, we'll also cover some of the SAP advanced topics. So these topics will not be related to certification, but it's very useful for projects that what is advanced analytics coming, like what do we have in SAP predictive analysis, some new BI tools which is coming like SAP Lumira or Crystal reports. So this part will be coming in our last session of SAP HANA advanced topics. So this is the all which we are going to cover in our the whole training session. So I will just pause here for a couple of seconds to ask you that if anybody of you is having any question related to the content, anything which you want to see here which is missing, okay, or your understanding is something else with the simple logistics. Any question we have now, we can take it related to the content.
Yeah, Parminder, I do have one question. Sure. I am a SD consultant, SD Elite. Okay, so yeah. Here we can see that the enterprise management, sales, sourcing and procurement, simplifications with manufacturing, means MMPP also there. Means I need to have a thorough knowledge of MMPP like that, or I need to only concentrate on the SD part?
So what you need to do is you need to more concentrate on the SD part, but you need to go to the overview of what are the changing coming. So that is a quite standard question we have in all of our sessions, that earlier people are coming from the different backgrounds, right? they are the separate SD consultant, MM consultant, but Simple Logistics is putting all of them together. And the certification exam will also be a group exam which will be covering all of them together. So there will be in the implementation projects, there will be separate SD consultants also. But for this course content, you can concentrate more on sales, but you can also use this course to expand yourself into the different area of procurement, PP, other areas. Although the in-depth knowledge is not required, only an overview will be sufficient. And the other thing is that if you will see the future of SAP, you know, when it started with, earlier it started with the core functional modules, right? Now you will see in the market, the more demand is the people who is having a multiple skills, who can handle a 2-3 modules together, okay? So that is the shift, and the drift is going from the market. So it's always having a good to have a strong hand on one module, but with the increasing years of experience, you will be required to have an overview of other modules and integration with them.
Okay, Parminder.
Okay. Any another question from any other participants on course content?
Yeah, Parminder, Sudhir.
Yeah.
On SAP Fiori experience, user experience, can you just elaborate what all you will be taking on that?
So SAP Fiori is, you know, the totally a new interface is there. So now when it is a new interface, actually it is made to use for the end users, but end users cannot use it without the help of a functional consultant for the first time. Okay. So we'll be covering here that as a functional consultant, what you are required to know about Fiori, okay? How you will be, how, because there are around 3,000 applications are there in Fiori. So as a functional consultant, you must be knowing that which of the Fiori applications which be useful for the end users and the clients, right? So we'll be covering here that how to check that which applications are useful, how to configure the applications, how to find the roles, because it's a totally a role-based environment, how to select the roles and how to configure SAP Fiori roles for the users. So that basic knowledge will be covered for SAP Fiori as a functional consultant.
Okay. Okay, if my understanding is correct, SAP Fiori, and if you check on Salesforce CRM on front-end, or the user experience, this can be put as competitors?
No. Salesforce is not a competitor for SAP Fiori. So if you will see the roadmap of SAP is to move, SAP roadmap is to eliminate GUI, our GUI interface. Okay. Then to move to NetWeaver, and from NetWeaver, SAP is recommending highly to clients to go with SAP Fiori, because that will be one interface which SAP wants to use in future as a single interface for the users to provide them insights. So Salesforce is not a competitor for Fiori.
Okay, similar to earlier we had SAP Web Dyn Pro, I think, right?
Yeah.
Where you have a web interface or something.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
Kind of that. I will give you a glimpse when we'll go into the demo of the application. I will give you a glimpse how do Fiori looks like.
Okay.
Now let's start with the history of SAP HANA. We are having some question that whether the what about the release of Simple Logistics, whether it's released or not. So we have two slides here. We'll be discussing that. We'll be answering all of your questions related to how the journey is happening with SAP HANA. So basically, SAP starts its journey in 1979 when they first come with R2. There's a two-tier model with the database and then the front end. So this was called as a first generation. So R2 in 1979, it comes with the first generation with R2. It's a two-tier model. Then SAP in 1990s, SAP moved to the R3 model. So in R3, they come with the three-tier model where we have a presentation layer at the top, then application layer, and then the database. And here in R3, a lot of additional features related to programming like iDocs, ALE and other things has been put in by SAP. It's also considered a big change, and it's called second generation of SAP solution. And around 2004, SAP come with solution of ERP, which is called Enterprise Core Component. Here basically SAP did a major work to integrate all of their solutions together, to integrate their making a core enterprise core component with integrating their core ERP solution with SRM solution, CRM solution, PLM solution, then their supply chain solution for APO, and then further going and integrating with EWM and event management systems. So that were in 2004 a major change come, SAP developing a core component that is called the third generation of SAP. Now we are right now we are at the fourth generation of SAP, which is called S/4HANA. Okay, the major change here in the fourth generation is HANA. HANA is underlined here. So up to R2, R3 and ERP, our ERP solution can work on any of the database. But in this fourth generation, this four is coming from the fourth generation basically. In this fourth generation, it is mandatory to have SAP HANA database. So S/4HANA has also launched, the earlier launch was happening for the Simple Finance. That was Simple Finance come actually in 1503. So here 15 is a year and third is a March. March 2015, SAP comes with their Simple Finance. And actually 1511, they come with their support pack one and making it as a S/4HANA. So 2015 in November, SAP launched their first support pack with S/4HANA. So 1511 was combining the Simple Finance of 1503 and then putting some solutions for Simple Logistics. So the question was there whether Simple Logistics is launched or not. Simple Logistics is very much launched in 1511. Okay, November 2015. The latest one for on-premise, we are having a 1610 version, which is the latest launch last year in October. That is with support pack 02. So that is the recent support pack for S/4HANA, support pack 02 with 1610. So here in 1610, we are having another improvements related to Simple Finance, and there are much more improvements has been done for Simple Logistics, and another technical things also has been changed. So new industry segments called retail, oil and gas has been recently introduced in 1610. So that is basically a journey for SAP. So that covers from R2 to S/4HANA, how SAP has moved step by step into the different generations. But even inside SAP HANA also, SAP has done a very good journey. A very beautiful journey to develop a very core competent product has been done. So let's now see here the briefly about the journey of SAP HANA. So SAP launched SAP HANA, which was earlier launched in 2011. Okay, so SAP is working for a long time. From a long time, SAP is working on SAP HANA, and they launched SAP HANA in 2011 itself. In 2011, it was just introduced as a database without having any component from the ECC. Okay, so it was just a base platform, a database platform, which can be used by any of the application, any of the tools in the market, so any of the ERP solutions can use it. It is open source. Now also it's open source, but after 2011, SAP has done a step-by-step journey to introduce a SAP product as embedded products into SAP HANA. Now, in 2012, SAP launched BW on HANA. So that is the first application which launched SAP on SAP HANA. So when BW and SAP HANA came, it improved the BW efficiency like exponentially up. The reports generation, the analytics have start happening into the BW very fast manner. But still, BW was on HANA, and our enterprise core component, which is ECC, was on another database. So still there was a lot of lag there. Then in 2013, SAP launched SAP Business Suite powered by SAP HANA. So there is a lot of confusion here, which creates, let's pay a little attention here, because in interviews also, when I ask this question many times, people are unable to answer. What is the difference between SAP HANA, enterprise on SAP HANA and S/4HANA? So these are the three different products, and Simple Finance also, because it is launched first, now it has been combined in S/4HANA. So we need to understand clearly what is SAP HANA, what is Business Suite on SAP HANA, and what is S/4HANA. So what is Business Suite on SAP HANA is nothing our ECC 6.0. Okay, we can also run our ECC 6.0 on SAP HANA. So it's our current business suite. We are running on a real-time data interface, which is the in-memory platform of SAP HANA. So we are running ECC 6.0 on SAP HANA platform. It is called a business suite for HANA. So a lot of improvement SAP has done with their ECC 6.0 Enhancement Pack 6, and then with Enhancement Pack 7, which make ECC 6.0 compatible to run on SAP HANA. So some of the improvement has been made to remove of the aggregation table, which started from the SAP Business Suite on HANA. Okay, so once they have moved from Business Suite on HANA, then the major change come in 2014, where SAP comes with a data model. A simplified data model actually comes with a Simple Finance, where the whole Simple Finance data model has been changed. A single source of truth for a single GL for all of your accounting entry, a single GL table has been made. So the database model changed in 2015, and Simple Finance came. So in 2014 last or 15 early, when Simple Finance came, so it only changed the data model of Simple Finance. Then with the change of 15.11 with Simple Logistic and S/4HANA come in 2015, we have more simplification in SAP Finance and simplification of data model for all of our logistics module. So here all of logistics module data model changed. Data model change means SAP removed all of the aggregation tables, SAP removed all of the index tables, and the whole database change. So that is the S/4HANA is a big change, because here when we change a data model, we need to do the whole coding change. So all of the coding part, all of the programming part has been rebuilt, redesigned in S/4HANA. That is called innovation. So when actually it started with in-memory database in 2011, when it is called come up, then in 2 years back, the competitors like IBM and Oracle also launched their in-memory database, but it doesn't mean that launching the in-memory database make those platform compatible with S/4HANA. S/4HANA is still an advanced technology compared to that databases, a 4 to 5 years of advanced technology because of their data model they have developed. A simplified data model is the key in S/4HANA. Okay, so now you will be clear that what is SAP HANA? It's just a database. It's more called as a appliance because it's a more capability. We'll see next that what additional capability SAP HANA has. SAP HANA as a database, any application run on database, there's a lot of innovative applications coming from the third parties, not belong to SAP. They are developing their applications on SAP HANA. When we call Business Suite on SAP HANA, is our ECC 6.0 on SAP HANA. Okay, when we call S/4HANA, is a Simple Logistics, Simple Finance with a new data model, with a new programming on SAP HANA. So that's the difference between all of the three components. Any question here on SAP journey? Now we'll move to SAP history. I will pause for 2-3 seconds to take if there is any question here. Okay, let's move to next slide, which is SAP history. So that is a story of SAP HANA, how SAP HANA built up an in-memory database. What was the requirement? Why they have built up? Let's see all of these questions. So they are the two key questions. Although we know that HANA is a new technology, HANA is a new thing, HANA is a future. But when we keep asking this question to the functional consultant or in the interviews, even after having a certification on HANA, they are not clearly they are not able to clearly explain why do we require a HANA. So that is the biggest question. What is HANA is the first question. Why do we require a HANA is a different question. And how do HANA is different from the another databases, from the another data models. So that are the key questions which everybody of us, when we look at HANA, we should have very much clarity. What is HANA and why do it require? Why do we require a HANA? So HANA is called a high performance analytical appliance. So that is a generally a definition given for HANA. But what I would say, HANA is just a name. Okay, you just consider it as a name of a database which has a very high capabilities, which is built on in-memory. It has application layer inbuilt in it. Okay, so it has a capability to run on two-tier model. And it has also capability to do the business analytics and the business calculation inside the database only. So that is what is HANA. So we'll go in detail that why HANA is required and why it is different from other database. So to answer that question, why we require SAP HANA? So let's discuss some of the scenario. The key requirement for SAP HANA is coming due to business innovations. So business is changing, business is changing like anything. A new innovations is coming. The deliveries will be done by the drones. Amazon has already started. Pizza delivered in 30 minutes, which will be transferred to 15 minutes. So the business is changing rapidly and in a very fast manner with coming of a lot of innovations. So when we talk about innovation, we need to also answer that the functional innovation which is coming in business is our SAP HANA, or is our IT, I will say that IT landscape. Do IT landscape is capable enough to handle those innovations? So let's do one thing here. I will put an example here. Okay, which will explain, which will try to, this is a real case example, a business case, which will try to explain logic behind what kind of requirements are coming from the business. So this is a real case of example where we are having a shoemaking company, okay, and that shoemaking company decided to have a new business innovation, where basically the shoes, the order of the shoes will be taken from the customers, okay, and it will be a customized orders, which means the customer will be making sales orders through web-based devices for a shoe, and they will be able to customize their shoe. Okay, they will be able to put what color they required, what kind of the laces they required, and what other they require, the feature they require in a shoe. Okay. And then that company has a target, once the order has been made, to deliver that shoe back in 6 to 7 days. This is a real-time example. And then that company is in US, United States, and it has a very complex business model. The manufacturing actually happens in China. Okay, so this is a company in US, manufacturing happens in China, it has a lot of distributors in between, then it has a distribution center in China, which takes from distribution centers. This is a USA distributions, this is a China distribution, and last we are having a plant who manufactures it in China. Now in this whole process model, you can see that the delivery need to be made in 6 to 7 days, and all of the logistics can happen in that period of time. So logistics is not a problem for that. But the major problem which was faced in this scenario to do a delivery in 6 to 7 days was IT. IT alone was taking a time of 2 to 3 days. So how IT is taking a time of 2 to 3 days? So IT has to transfer this demand sales order to the China and telling a China what components is required. There's a lot of IT system and IT landscape has been used which works on batch jobs like MRP. Our optimization engines for our sales order is having availability checks which runs on batch jobs, rescheduling job runs. So this all our runs on a batch job which we run overnight. So we receive the order 9 a.m. in the morning from the customer, and our MRP sits in between and it says, boss, I will run at night, I will take 8 to 10 hours, then I will shift my demand to China. Okay, so that MRP bad jobs, our supply chain management bad jobs, optimization engines take a lot of time and which we need to run at the night. So this all IT process can take easily 2 to 3 days, which is the biggest time in the whole supply chain model. So here we can clearly see that IT landscape is not capable enough to cope up with the changes which is coming from business innovations, right? And you know, the complications arises more when our US business is totally on a different landscape. It runs on a different ECC landscape and this runs on a different landscape. So we have two regions which runs two different SAPs. So integration with them is having another bad jobs, okay, which increase the complexity. So SAP understand that this current IT landscape is very complicated and there is an urge to simplify the whole landscape. And what SAP understands after doing a lot of brainstorming and after doing a lot of homework is that with the current technology that cannot happen. With only writing a good programs cannot make us capable enough to adopt the business innovations. So what we need, we actually need a new hardware which can make this batch jobs to be run from 8 to 10 hours to run on a real time within 5 to 10 minutes. So that is the biggest change. You can imagine that a MRP batch job which is taking 8 hours, with the SAP HANA we can run it within a 10 minutes to 15 minutes. So that the whole the supply and the demand chain can work on real time. So to SAP understand that there is a requirement of a new platform, there is a requirement of a new hardware which is called SAP HANA database, and then they come up with the new solution that new hardware is required, and they made SAP HANA on in-memory database. So why we require SAP HANA? Because we need to adopt business innovations. Okay, we need to run our supply chain models on real time. We need to provide a real-time insight to the users, okay, and real-time insights can only work when our all of the processes runs in a lightning speed on real time. So then only we can get a real-time data analytics. So that is one of the example that why we require SAP HANA. Then now I will quickly explain you before I move it to the showing you the system part. I will just quickly explain you that what is the history of SAP HANA, and before understanding that we should have a understanding what is a traditional database. So until and unless we don't understand a traditional database, we will not be able to appreciate SAP HANA. So the main problem in the traditional database is it runs on a disk. That is the main problem. So we have a mechanical devices on which data is stored. Okay, so when the mechanical devices is happening, so when we try to fetch the data, okay, it takes a lot of time. So there are the two parts here. One is OLAP, one is called OLAP, and one is called OLTP. This online application processes and online transaction processes. So this traditional database can still work good, okay, with OLTP. OLTP still works fine, but when it comes with OLAP, where we need to generate analysis, analytical reports, the performance is very poor. That's why we go with the solution of business warehouse to putting a new database and having redundant data. So here basically presentation tier required and send a query to application tier, and that send it to the database. Database do all of the collection of data, put it in one cache and input output files, send it back to application layer. Application layer, all of the calculations, so all of the calculation programs are written on application layer, which increase the load on application, and then final results has been fetched to our presentation layer. So that was the traditional database. So because it's on the disk, data is on the disk, it takes a lot of time. So what is then in-memory database? Let's go to next slide. In-memory database, the major change in in-memory database is data is not stored in the disk. So where the data is stored then? Data is stored in charge. Data is stored in capacitors and transistors. Okay, so when we say capacitor and transistor and charge, it means a charge is required all the time so that we have saved the data. You can easily compare an in-memory database with your RAM or dynamic RAM in memory. So what happens here, because all of the things, you can believe that all of your, if all of your laptops 520 GB data, we convert it and provide you a RAM of 520 GB, how fast the processing would be. You can imagine that. So there is no additional requirement to fetch the data from the database disk system, which is taking a lot of time. So this in-memory improves OLAP part drastically, online analytical processing part. Okay, and we are also having innovative CPUs, and the problem with that CPU technology has built up so fast by Intel by putting up different cores of CPUs and the data CPUs, that CPU was always data hungry, and our traditional database were always slow. They were not able to provide data to CPUs, right? Now here CPUs, on core CPUs can directly work on the in-memory. They can do all of the calculations which were earlier was done on the application layer, we can directly do in the database. All of the calculations, aggregations, filters, we can do on the database, and then final results is put it, we have put it to the application layer, sorry, to the presentation layer. So SAP has also done some major acquisition to make this happen, to make this possible, SAP HANA. So they have acquired Trax Engine, they have acquired PStar Time, they have acquired MaxDB. Okay, so as I have explained here that the charge is required. So what is the problem with in-memory database is if we lose the power, okay, if the complete power shutdown happen, we can lose all of the memory, okay, which means that we can lose all of the data. So that's why it is must very much required that we also require a traditional database to have a backup. So SAP required three major acquisition in history to make this appliance happen. So what are the three different things? Trax is a search engine which is also used by PW system. It has an excellent column based driven reporting and computation. So we'll be going into detail that what is a column storage, what is a row storage in our detailed sessions. So this Trax system is basically for doing a computation very fast. So it is basically for OLAP improvements. SAP has implemented, acquired that and integrated with SAP HANA. PStar Time is having an engine which has a great performance with OLTP. Okay, so that has been put it to improve the transaction processings. And MaxDB is a traditional database which can store the data into the database so that in case, although it doesn't happen, but in case if the complete shutdown happens, SAP will be having a capability to store all of the data. And they also did another acquisition, the SLT is also one of them, system landscape transformation, so that the system landscape transformation can happen easily from the old ECC system to new S4 systems. So this is basically the journey of SAP HANA. I have covered this quickly. We will be going in very much details of all of the things when we go into this our detailed sessions. So this is all about the whole architecture of SAP HANA. The major change is pushed down. It has pushed down the all of the calculations part from the application layer to the database. And even the application layer is also inbuilt on SAP HANA. So SAP HANA is having a functionality to work on two-tier or three-tier architectures. Okay, so because it's an in-memory database, it has a processing engine, it can run the computation very fast. So rather than having a code on application layer and do the computation on application layer, now we can do all of our analysis on database itself. Now database don't provide the data to the application and the presentations. They directly provide the results. And all of our ECC system can integrate with it. Third party system can integrate with it. VW can run with it. So you can imagine the power of SAP if you have a different landscape. Everybody can use a single database, even your third parties. So when the database is together there in SAP HANA, you have immense capability to run reports from your ECC, combining your data from ECC and third party. Earlier, it's a big project to combine the data from the two different databases. So that is the key capabilities of SAP HANA. So if I will summarize SAP HANA, that what key feature it is coming with up, it's having an in-memory database, it has an application layer, excellent analytical software analysis capabilities, effective data compression with the row-based column structure, a push-down mechanism, and it also has a traditional database to have a backup of the data. So that is the key SAP HANA in itself. Now we will quickly go to the system part. Here we'll see what are the things actually we'll be learning from the system perspective, HANA Studio and Fiori and other things. So before I move to system part, I will pause here for a few seconds to take question. If you have any question on the SAP HANA, what is SAP HANA, why do we require, and how it is different with the traditional database system. Any question on that topic, you can ask now. Okay, so if there's no question, let's go and see that what things we'll be seeing. So I will just provide a glimpse. I will just provide a glimpse of the all of the things from our landscape. So this will be our S4HANA 1610 SAP system. Okay, so this is first interface, which is called SAP GUI interface. We all are well aware with SAP GUI, okay, and there's no change in SAP GUI. It's all same. So this is on SAP HANA database, okay. How do we know? Because it looks same. How do I know it's on SAP HANA or it's still on my ECC 6.0 running on a SQL database? So let's check. Go to system, go down to status. You can see here that it is on hosted on a HANA database. Okay. And owner is SAP ABAP 1. So this is important, SAP ABAP 1. SAP ABAP 1 is a schema. Because as we said that HANA database can be used by different systems. So it can be also different SAP system using a single SAP HANA. So the data for the different system is stored in different schemas, which we'll discuss in detail later on. But this is a schema name which we have here as an owner, right? And this is on a HANA database. And here you can see that S4 core component has been applied on that. So this is on S4 business suite on HANA database. We can find it from here. So from the using point of view, there's not much changes in GUI. It's all same. Although there are some new transactions coming and some transaction has been removed, some table has been removed. But right now the old transactions works. Okay, only thing is that in background it triggered the new transaction or the new views created. Okay, but right now the old transaction and old table still works. If you want to see that what are the different functions, business function has been activated by SAP HANA. So when you are in S4 HANA, if you go in SFW5, SFW5 is a T code which I am trying to run. If you are already on the level of architecture, you might be knowing that this is a business function transaction code. So here you will be seeing a new tab coming up with S4 HANA, which is S4 HANA always on functions. So when we apply our S4 core component, these are the all of the business functions which SAP has changed and which is part of simplification also. Okay, so these all are the business functions which has been introduced by S4 HANA to improve and to simplify the business suite. So you can see here the finance related functions are there. You can see SD related functions or other thing. If you want to go in detail of anything, you can click here and then you can go in detail. I will also give you a little glimpse of a new transaction code, which is very important from project perspective, is /N, if you want to note it down, /SMB/BBI. That is a solution builder. So what solution builder provide, it tells you that what are the best practices available for SAP HANA. Okay, SAP S4 HANA delivers their best practices through this solution builder. It also helps you to do your configuration. So this is very helpful now for a greenfield projects. So these all of the best practice solution has been listed here. If you want to change some of them, you can also go ahead and create a new your new business practices here. So if you want to check what is the return to supplier best practice, you can go and click here. Okay, so it will be opening in a web page where you will be able to see that for that return to supplier as a best practice, what is process model there, and if you want to test it, what test scripts required. Okay, so you can open here, a system tells you that you need to create a purchase order, then production planner, warehouse clerk need to do some of the work. Okay, so the whole process of return to supplier, you can see it here. That is the best practice delivered by S4 HANA. Okay, so this tool, the solution builder tool, is widely used and is recommended to use, especially for the new projects. It also uses to make your business blueprints. Okay, and for the migration projects, once you have a migration from old ECC system and the new ECC system, from old ECC system we use SD11 to get what are the linkage of the data sources, and here we use a solution builder to find it out that what the changes will be coming in our business blueprint. Okay, we'll go into the both of them in detail. I'm just providing you a glimpse that what are the new things coming. So that is from the GUI part. So we'll go into the detail of the simplification, transaction, other things once we are in the system. Let's quickly go to our HANA Studio. HANA Studio is the biggest change from interface side of point of view for the functional consultant. Functional consultant will be given access to HANA Studio and they will be supposed to work on HANA Studio. It's a very capable tool which can work. A BAPRS can work on that, data modeler can work on that, analytics and analysis can happen on that, functional experts can work on that. Only it is not recommended for end users to use it. Also, we can also provide access to that for our key or super users. So once you will open that HANA Studio, as soon as you open here, if you are opening it first time, the page you will be seeing is this. You will see a welcome page. So basically in the welcome page, you can open a different kind of people can work on the their different kind of views. Okay, you are a modeler, so you can go into the modeler view. Or if you're an administrator, you can go the administrator view. These are the perspective, how the views little bit change when you see the HANA Studio, it little bit change here. Okay, then it also has all of the support part. If you need any support, if you need any help, all of the content is here. Okay, what the fundamental task is, what is the quick launch. If you need help on any of them, you can click here. SAP will take you to the to their help guide. So help guide has a detail and the information where you can read that which function does the what things. So this kind of help guide is there for all of these things. So you need to go into the open modeler. So once you reach here, this is our system, okay, which has already been configured. So in HANA Studio, we can configure multiple systems with multiple usernames. Okay, once you will do a drill down here, you will see the different thing here, catalog and content. Catalog is the one which will be having a different schema. Okay, as we see that our schema is SAP ABAP one. Schema is just a hierarchical structure, nothing else. So we can go here in SAP ABAP one. Here we have a different kind of procedures. Indexes. Procedure is nothing but programs, and we also have a tables. So now all of our tables are stored here. If you want to search for a table, you can right click, you can go to find table. Let's say we want to search for Mara table. So you can see here the different tables are there coming from the different schemas. So let's search only, we want to only go for Mara. This is Mara. We go here, we click on OK. Here system will be opening the definition. That this is the definition. And here you can notice that it's a column store. In our earlier traditional database, this was not a column store. This was a row structure. Okay, here it's a column-based structure. So that is also one of the change. Also one of the change. You can from here you can see the runtime informations. Okay, the what are the number of records and what is the size it has been covering this table. So all of the tables views are quickly available here and we can do all of the analysis here with the tables also. So let me take you into the next view, which is content. Content is basically where we will be creating views. So we need to create a different views like attribute views, analytical views, calculation views. View is nothing but a logical structure. Okay, if you go into one of the analytical views, so what we do here is that we can take a different data stores, different data from the different tables, and then we can combine it here. So no coding is required to combine this data, to put some business logics. it is all done based on the graphical structures. So we can put some calculations, we can put some joints, we can club some tables. Everything can happen here by a function consultant without doing any coding. So that is the biggest change as a data modeling knowledge you should have, that this is a capability SAP HANA is having to create a data views. So all of the aggregation tables will be replaced by data views, because in data view we are just creating a structure, it doesn't store any data. So when somebody uses it, then system, by using that structure, system took the data from the main tables and show the results. Let's go here in one of the calculation view. Let's click it here. So this is a calculation view has been created. We'll go in detail. We'll be having a very detailed session to understand these three different views and to how to create them. And if you click right click here, we are having a functionality here, a data preview. You can see here that based on this calculation view, what is the output of data. So here basically you can do all of the, you can see here the raw data. If you want to see the distinct value, how many customers are there, you can see how many products are there, you can see. So this happens really fast, the kind of the things from tables. If you work on SA 16 or 16N, we are running a kind of a sales order item table on plant level, where plant is not a key field. Then it takes a lot of time even to get the what are the number of records there, but here it happens on the lightning speed. And the functional consultants can also do some kind of analysis here, okay, with the data. So here you can put a different kind of graphs. Although this kind of graphs cannot be shared by application directly from here, there are the different ways to generate analytics for end users. But for functional consultants, for the data scientists, can very much use these tools to have an analysis on top of the data which they have. So you can go with here the different kind of graphs, a lot of graphs available, that analysis you can do. Okay, and then doing a quickly analysis, you can save that graphs, or you can also download it and then share with the another people. That is the first part of the analysis you can quickly do from here. So the playing with the data in SAP HANA is very simple, very easy. And you can, by seeing the data, by doing some of the mappings, you can come up and do your analysis on SAP HANA Studio itself. Okay. So different kind of graphs are available here. We also have a heat map. So that is just to give you a glimpse that what kind of capabilities HANA Studio has and what things will be doing it on top of HANA Studio. Now let me go and show you what we have in Fiori. So Fiori is a web-based tool. It can also work as an application on mobile apps, or it can work on our browsers. So you can see here that we have a different tabs here, and there is no T code there, right? So we'll be having a storyboard. Let's say this is a storyboard for a inventory manager who used to do the inventory analysis. Okay, so he can use it. You can see here there will be different tabs here. Let's say to manage stock, to see the stock for multiple materials. So Fiori cannot do the transactions. Although it can do the transaction, but all of the transaction cannot be done by Fiori. Generally, it is based to provide the insights. So functional consultants will be there who will be describing that which user roles should have which kind of application. Sorry. So each of the box here act as application. So let's say if we want to post a good receipt, we click it here. So we can do the purchase order here and do the transaction from here. So the concept is, right now the data is not there, so it doesn't show the values, but we need to configure a storyboard by using SAP Fiori. I will halt my demo here, and now we will open for a question and answer session where you can ask if any questions do you have. You can use chat window to type your question, or feel free to unmute yourself and ask question if you do have any. Anindya, Himanshu, Mubarak, Murthy, any question? So we have one question here coming from Sudhir. Sudhir says that, can you tell me how many days the session will be and how many hours? So so this will be having on the weekends only, Saturday and Sunday. Every weekend we'll be having around 2 to 3 hours of sessions. So we'll try to complete it in 2 months, or around, you can say that 16 to 20 sessions will take to complete it on weekends. Yes, Sudhir has a question that, do we get any practice system? Yes, you will be getting access to the practice system, the same system which we'll be discussing. The same system access you will be getting, a remote desktop access you will be getting. So you will get.
I have a question.
Yeah, Vivek.
So when we are doing this mock, whatever in the online practice in the system, mm-hmm. So do we have anything, some like scenarios, test scenarios, like scripts, or where, you know, end to end scenario where we, you know, creation of from simple logistic perspective, creation of purchase order, or, you know, or then go into sales order, creation of sales order, delivery, billing. Do we have this kind of, you know, some set of scripts
or
scenarios where
we will be having a scenarios, we'll be having a script also. But script and scenarios will not be like that to create a sales order or to create a purchase order, because creating a sales order, creating a purchase order, there is nothing going to change in S/4HANA. So our scripts will be a little different, where we'll be giving an exercise to you in SAP HANA database that you need to create different kind of views based on scenarios or based on a problem coming from MM side or ST side. You need to club to different tables, create a view, and taking that view, you need to generate some analytics by using some of the analytical reporting. So that kind of scripts will be there, because creating a purchase order, creating a sales order, there's nothing changing in S/4HANA. Although you can go ahead and create in the system to check it. So we'll have a little different kind of scripts.
So Pramila, basically this is the base configuration and everything will be still be done in R3. Here only we are just, you know, the views are changing. It's like kind of a BW kind of thing. We are just putting the views, and but basic configuration is always will be on R3 system, right?
No, it's not on R3 system. So it depends on what kind of project we have. So if we have a migration project, right? So our configurations are already there in ECC side, right? So in the migration mm-hmm. project, we do the all of the migration from ECC to S/4HANA. Okay, so everything mm-hmm. comes on S/4HANA. In the migration project, you need not to do any configurations, right? Because the configurations mm-hmm. are already there. Yeah. But when you come to the S/4HANA, the same kind of, you can use SAP GUI to do your configuration changes if you require to do any. And there will be some of the changes which we'll be discussing, that there is a material length is changing, what to do with that, how to make sure that all of our codes are consistent with that. So there's few configuration which is there, which we'll be discussing, which we need to specifically check for S4HANA that we need to do. Mm-hmm. If it is a fresh implementation and client is directly going with S4HANA, then in the same way you need to do all of the configurations in S4HANA, and you can use the solution builder tool which can help you to do the configurations, which can guide you to do the configurations.
Mm-hmm. So the basically configuration where we go into SPR and do the, it will be the same in
it would be exactly same. So only thing that there is a very many new functions coming up. If changes is happening in inventory, a lot of tables we have removed. SAP has removed a lot of tables, aggregated tables. So when you prepare a functional specs, SAP recommend that now we don't go to the aggregated tables. Although it is still there, we need to directly use the views which is there available other than that aggregated tables. And you know, the major shift is happening for the analyticals part. The analytics is driving for S4HANA because analytics is slowly coming into the hand of functional consultant, and with the coming years, the drive of analytics will directly go to the end users, where end users will be directly taking data from the tables, or with the, some very smart views mentioned, they will be doing their analytics.
Okay. So mostly whatever it was, see if the now the existing all the systems, I mean the companies are running on R3, and when this S4HANA is going live or people are migrating, so mostly of the project will be migration, then really fresh S4HANA implementation, right?
That's very true. Most of the projects will be the migration projects, and you will see the drift of the migration projects more when SAP will trying to push that they are going to stop the support of ECC system, which will happen after 2020. Then there will be a major flood of the projects of migration. But yeah, there are the new projects are also there. So there are many clients which right now doesn't use SAP HANA. When they are coming for SAP HANA, so SAP is recommending them to directly go for S4HANA. And the major and the big clients also go with the newer technology. So SAP S4HANA is also helping SAP to bring new clients also, because the technology is totally different than the another ERP. It's a 5 to 6 year ahead technology, which others doesn't have.
Okay. yeah, thanks, Parminder.
Sure. Any other question?
Sure. Yeah, Parminder. Yeah, Swen here.
Yes, Parminder. Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, my question is here. You know that in ARC, we have integrated with other modules like SD, FI, MM, PPTM, like that. As per the requirement of the business. So how that scope of hearing simple and stick?
Sorry, can you please repeat the question? There was a lot of background noise, so I was not able to hear.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Yeah, my question is, we know that in RT we have integrated with different modules like FI, SD, MM, PPM, right?
Mm-hmm.
So on that way, if I think for that S4HANA logistic, how the scope of here? So how we can integrate it with the other modules as per the requirement of the business, how we can convert into a report like that?
Yeah, so basically what happens is the integration remains the same, the way that MM integrates with the WM, or the way the PP integrates with the QM, or SD integrates with the inventory management. The basic and the core things remain same here. That is not changing.
Okay.
So that integration, what earlier was there and what now is there, it remains same. There's no change in that integrations. There's a new feature has been introduced. Okay. So there's a from integration with MRP side, there's a new feature of MRP Live which is coming into the picture. That's a totally a new feature. Okay, so there are some certain new features which has been introduced in each of the modules, which we'll be going in details once we'll be covering the simplification part.
So one more question for you. Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
See, you could see that as for the client requirement, they have implemented other interfaces or other modules, other ERP systems. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So we are fetching the data to that SAP system, to the program or whatever interface or IDOS, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So on that point, how that simple logistics, S/4HANA simple logistics, how it could be helpful?
Yeah, sure. So basically, I also saw your question on the chat window about the migrations also. So what happened in S/4HANA is, let's say this is our HANA. Okay. So this HANA has a capability that it can integrate with the ECC system.
Okay.
It can also integrate with the third party systems. So there will be multiple business cases there. So only in business case would not be there that the migration. There can be a business case where the ECC system stand here as there. Okay. So business doesn't want to move from ECC. They for 2-3 years, they just want to use the ECC. But they want to use the capability of HANA. Okay. So what can be done, and that data can be taken from ECC to HANA. So for data migration, there is a multiple tools are there. We have a SLT, we have a BODS, we have a Smart Data Access. So we'll be going in detail of all of these tools. So let's say the SLT has been used, system landscape transformation. So SLT can continuously fetching the data to the HANA system, and from here we can run our analytics reporting. Okay. So this is the way we can do a batch job from ECC to SAP HANA, taking the data and doing our analytics on top of HANA, right? Or for migration also, when we need to do migration by doing SLT, we bring all of the data into the HANA. When it connects to the third party, generally we use BODS. We don't use SLT, it's not recommended. We use BODS tool to bring the real-time data into the HANA. So once the data is there in HANA, there is a first schema having data from ECC. We have a second schema having a data from third party. So all of the data is here. So multiple third party can connect to the SAP HANA and they use the SAP HANA database. So once all of the data is there in HANA, you can create a view combining these two data. Okay. And do analytics on top of that. So there's a lot of business cases coming. So we have done an implementation where without touching the ECC system, ECC system will be as it is. Do the data migration to the HANA and run analytics on top of HANA. Okay, so that kind of business cases or business scenarios also coming. So we'll discuss in the session when we'll go to the architecture that what can kind of a different scenarios we have for SAP HANA, what different kind of migrations we have, or implementation scenarios we have.
My last question is here.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
My last question is for that requirement of that business, we are preparing some architect layout which is not available in the standard SAP. So that we are customizing. So on that basis, we are creating some new database, like new tables or new G tables for storing the data, right?
Mm-hmm.
So on that way, if you think about the surface for S/4HANA logistic, so on that same similar kind of way we need to follow up, or we need to you have certain kind of facilities like that, we need not to do develop like G tables or whatever. Maybe. You have some tables here or how?
Yeah, so good question. So in SAP HANA, the basic key things is simplification. So what SAP HANA is doing, it's removing a table, it's removing unnecessary aggregate tables. So there is no more adding of the tables, right? So rather than creating a Z table to run analytics or to run a report, the Z table in future, earlier we were creating a Z table. Now SAP recommends we should create a view.
Okay.
Okay. So what is the difference between Z table and view? In Z table, basically we store the data, right? View is a logical structure. Okay. So SAP is also having a functionality. Let's say you can have a two different HANA system. It is a two different servers. Let's say it's a big company for US and India business. They want to run on the different HANA systems. This is US HANA. And you want a report all together with US HANA and India HANA, India business. Okay. So there's no need to do any data transfer between these two, neither from here to here or nor from here to here. Without doing any data transfer, HANA is having a functionality which is called Smart Data Access, SDA. So you can create a view here which can use the data from here. Okay, so a logical structure, whenever it is required, it will be go into this system, read the data from here and provide you analytics. So without even doing any data transfer here, in this case, even rather than creating a Z table, no data transfer, just create a view, use both of the data sets altogether and generate a report from it. So that kind of scenarios are also possible.
From the point of view of performance issue, how soon we can get that report? Let's say it depends upon their filtration of that data. We are fetching from RT while we are fetching the data from the RT. Let's say we are running one transaction code or batch or whatever maybe. It's taking a lot of time. So on that point of view, how soon we can get that report or any data we fetch from the HANA database?
Yeah, so there's two questions here in your question. One is the performance of report and the second is the life cycle of report. Okay. So performance of report will be drastically improved. We are having a business here where in AFS industry we have allocation runs. So allocation runs are taking a time up to, it happened in the night batch job and it can take up to 8 to 10 hours. That in SAP HANA we have reduced to up to 10 minutes. So that kind of a big difference you can see here. That's why SAP has introduced MRP Live, which is taking many hours, but now we can just run it as required. Every 10 minutes, every 15 minutes, we can run it. So that performance will improve due to a column-based storage and due to our data compressed and used in memory. So performance will increase and the reporting will be very fast. Some of the reports you will be able to generate by yourself. So as I explained that we have seen the creation of views. So once a view is created, we are having here some of the features like we'll go in detail later, is SAP Lumira. So the views you create, you can use this tool SAP Lumira to put take your views here and generate the reports yourself. So many of the reportings a functional consultant will be able to provide without even doing any developments. And here also user will also be having a functionality from your data set which you have provided a view. They will be able to alter, they will be able to play with the data with multiple variables and generate reports with this SAP Lumira.
And one more question, for that SAP HANA logistic to access that configuration of our system is normal as like RT or as how it is, you need to upgrade it or else?
So if it's a question related to configuration, it is same. Okay. Only thing we need to check our simplification, that what area we are working, if there's any simplification and additional configuration we need to check. We're going in detail of that part. So that remains same with the simplification list we'll be discussing. That will come one new thing. Okay. And the upgrades and the things need to be done by the system admins. So SAP HANA is having for on-premise they'll be having one upgrade every year, okay? And for the cloud solution, there will be a quarterly upgrades. So cloud, we have an upgrade every quarter. And on-premise solution will be upgraded per year. And on-premise, it's a responsibility of client to upgrade it. And on cloud, SAP upgrade by themselves. That is on upgrades.
So for that server access, through RHC we can get connected to that direct server.
Sorry, can you please repeat?
For that in that remote access, we can get that access from the server directly.
Yes, that's the same window which you can see now. Same kind of window you will see. You need to put remote access. Everything is here. No need to install anything. Everything, HANA Studio, SAP, UI, Fiori, NWC, everything is here.
Thanks.
Okay, sure. Any further questions or shall we close the session? Okay, so before closing the session, I will just make a point that it's a very good time. It's just the start of the year. It's a good time to go ahead with the new technologies and the new courses like Simple Logistics, because we have seen that once Simple Finance was launched in this year and in the last year, and also clients are aggressively going with the Simple Finance. Okay, now with the Simple Logistics by this quarter and coming from the third quarter, there will be huge demand coming for the Simple Logistics and Simple Logistics project. So all of the consultants with their basic knowledge on SDMM, and with the top of that, they also know what SAP HANA is and what SAP HANA can do. It will be great achievement for your profile and you will be open to a bigger market. Okay, so thank you everybody. Thank you for joining your session. Thank you for giving your time. I hope you to see you in our training sessions.
Yes.
Have a great day.
Thanks for
that. Bye-bye.
Yeah, you too. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.